Trot was the first to recover. Disengaging herself from Cap'n Bill's wet embrace and sitting up, she rubbed the water from her eyes and then looked around her. A soft bluish-green glow lighted the place, which seemed to be a sort of cavern, for above and on either side of her were rugged rocks. They had been cast upon a beach of clear sand, which slanted upward from the pool of water at their feet, a pool which doubtless led into the big ocean that fed it. Above the reach of the waves of the pool were more rocks, and still more and more, into the dim windings and recesses of which the glowing light from the water did not penetrate. The place looked grim and lonely, but Trot was thankful that she was still alive and had suffered no severe injury during her trying adventure underwater. At her side, Cap'n Bill was sputtering and coughing, trying to get rid of the water he had swallowed. Both of them were soaked through, yet the cavern was warm and comfortable, and a wetting did not dismay the little girl in the least. She crawled up the slant of sand and gathered in her hand a bunch of dried seaweed, with which she mopped the face of Cap'n Bill and cleared the water from his eyes and ears. Presently the old man sat up and stared at her intently. Then he nodded his bald head three times and said in a gurgling voice,
"Mighty good, Trot, mighty good. We didn't reach Davy Jones' locker that time, did we? Though why we didn't, and why we're here, is more than I can make out."
"Take it easy, Cap'n," she replied. "We're safe enough, I guess, at least for the time being." He squeezed the water out of the bottoms of his loose trousers, and felt of his wooden leg and arms and head, and finding he had brought all of his person with him, he gathered courage to examine closely their surroundings.